Dispatcher to UP4752 at Colfax. Two eastbounds to contend with. First, UP3687 auto train, which is coming alongside you as we speak. You will follow him up the pass, which means yellow signals. Second train, UP3300 POTS, on the approach and will stop at the signal bridge for a crew change. Okay to proceed east when signal indicates. Dispatcher Thompson out. That signal indicates, but that one doesn't. We've got that one coming up the inside there. Steam goodness. One thing I really like about Steve's scenarios is the all the people. Really brings it to life. So what's really neat is that now these steam trains have stopped, the scripting that I actually set up for these means that as soon as they start moving, the cylinder box will open automatically, which is quite neat. Except apparently they're not doing that. Alright, fine. Supposed to. There's the back of the train, and my job is to basically keep up with it. It is indeed neighbour, I think we'll find. Well, you've got to think that with there being a double-header Challenger, there's a bit like having four big steam engines on the front. Watching my signal over there for when it's time for me to go. Shouldn't be too much longer now. Hey Marcus, welcome to the channel this evening. Very odd, JJ. They should just follow the speed limit. Okay. Front loco to the right. I mean, this one looks like a GP9. Have we got the clear to go yet? Nope. Oh, I see what you mean, JJ. Yes, you have to, it will always try and achieve a percentage of the line speed. Well, come on, give me my light. Yellow. Let's get the heck out of here. Pour the power on. Come on, get it moving. We're just leaving Colfax at the moment. Firebrand, the reason it looks like it deforms it is because I'm moving it forwards or backwards at the same time. It's a bit like the Hitchcock effect. Donna dispatched to UP 4752. Traffic is going to be moderate to heavy today, as you already know by now. Track crews and a lot of other workers and people are all along the pass today, mainly because of the great weather. Keep the horn blowing when needed. Compton out. Hey Sapphire, thanks for joining us. Okay. Oh, thank you, Coplopper. We're in a 25, so we're not going to see much power. Welcome back, Ninja Joker, and welcome to Chroma N. Okay, so we've got a yellow signal, so we just need to be aware of that as we're coming along. Missed the whistle board for that. Oops. Hey there, Dewey Colf, Hockey Player. Welcome back to the channel. Good to have you with us. There's this signal. Hello, we've got people down there. Yeah, you're right, Ed. It could do with some sort of repeater. Do you mean slow, JD? Do you mean frame rate? Hey there, Tricky Wiz. Welcome to the panel this evening. 80% of all UK trains look the same. Funny. Hey there, Chris Boss. Wow, that's a long way down. Realise we were going a bit slow there, so pulling the speed back up again. This route is just stunning, isn't it? It really is superb. I think the point is, if you don't really understand or dig into the particular ins and outs of them, then they will all look the same. Hey there, Chris Boss, thanks for the follow, much appreciated. Signal, another yellow signal, excellent. Of it before I started working at Dovetail, or RouseSim.com as it was back in the day, I didn't have much of an appreciation for American trains, and I took it upon myself to fix that, since I was dealing with all sorts of different country stuff with third party. And yeah, when you dig into it and you start spending time looking at the different locos, you start seeing all the differences. And then they start looking very different. So, still not there yet, but I'm getting there. I still can't tell the difference between an AC6000, an ES44, a Dash 9, AC4400. They all look the same to me. Hey, they're good pay. But that's because I can't see the difference. That doesn't mean they aren't the same. Doesn't mean they are the same. They've got the same, all the aspects I generally look at in locos are very similar. Window formations, what trucks it's got, how the grills look like on the back, the radiator, the fans and so forth on the top. Would that be a red signal for me? No, it's not. It's a yellow. Speed up. No, it doesn't, JJ. I've got an 8 gauge model of the billet Nianor version. There's some steep grades on this line up here. Hey JJ, you can add any scenery you like in a scenario and it becomes there only for that particular scenario. So it's scenario specific scenery. If you go and have a look at my tutorial on creating a passenger scenario, I cover doing that sort of thing. But yes, you can customize the scenery on the route. You can't delete anything, you can't move anything, but you can add stuff and move the stuff that you've added around. Which means you can really do some great stuff, as Steve has done here, to customize the whole way that the scenario looks, adding your own personal touch to the world and making the world a bit different. It's a really underused feature in the game, and it's something I definitely really like seeing when people do use it. Hey there, Formless friend. Welcome to the channel. Thanks for joining us. I think, like I said, I think, JJ, if you make changes to the route, people won't see it. But if you add stuff. There we go, we haven't got an red yellow light, so we are good to continue. We've got an approach light there. Yeah, so if you make changes to the route, then because you're only distributing a scenario, people won't see it. But it is possible to add scenario-specific stuff. That's been possible since TS 2012, if I remember rightly, at least TS 2012. Hey Chris Boss, this is in Donner Pass. We're actually heading eastbound up the western slope. Oh, I would, JJ. Now, you should all get uploaded to Steam Workshop as well. In fact, obviously it does, because that's where this scenario came from. You can't change the track work, obviously. Even it's basically just replacing straightforward assets now. Getting up on the next leg at 2.4%, I guess, grade, which is pretty steep. Our next waypoint is Magra Track 2, which is in 0.6. That's correct, JJ. Any sort of static assets that come with the route you can place, so you can put more trees down, put logs down. You could say, for example, that a line is out of service, so they're being rerouted because a tree has fallen down, and then actually put a tree fallen down across the line. Or if some workmen are working on the line, you could put people there and various bits of ballast all over the track and so forth. So you can actually make the world change according to reflect what you're seeing is happening. I don't know, JJ. You can change track rules, track settings, track properties. So in the passenger scenario at the end, I actually changed the directionality of the track to allow my service to go through. And that was just done on a scenario specific basis. Just checking the signal. We have got an approach signal. It's not so much hard getting the train up the hill. Here we go. Thompson to UP 4752 at Magra. You'll be holding at the eastbound signal at Gold Run for a few minutes. So, so you can change track properties in a scenario, which I think includes speed limits, so you might be able to do that. No such thing as a short freight train in America. I think we're on notch 7 now, so there's not much more power to give. That looks like we're speeding up. Yeah. 2.6%. Wow. That's cool, Chris. What did you think of them? No, you can't, Ed. If you've routed a train through a location, then unless there's anything blocking it, then it will let them through. I think I've got three SC40s on the back providing pushing power, plus my three locos on the front, so there's a fair amount of horsepower on this train. In the back of the train is three SD40-2s, by the looks of it. Thanks, Chris. Really appreciate that feedback. That's it. We're in notch 8 now. That's it. I've got no more power to give to this train. We've got an approach signal in front of us, so we're good to keep going. Hey, the Gaming Lab. Welcome to the channel this evening. I think they make money, Dave, because of the length of their freight trains. Shipping this much freight in one go is tremendously efficient. Nothing beats it. How long has this journey been? I can't remember what time we started, actually. Been going a little while now. I saw some spectacular figures about particularly the ES44, and I think it's the amount, number of gallons of fuel to move a ton a mile or something like that, averaged out. It's ridiculous, as in very, very low. No, and the point is, dominant Ed, you couldn't actually take this train any faster than that. 25 really is the practical speed limit for this track. Yeah, that looks more like the figures that I saw, JJ. It's astounding. I always enjoy driving this route. Lots to see, and the way that it steps its way up the hill keeps you on your toes. Hey, Six String! Welcome to the channel this evening. Yes, I've got that one written down as well. That one's 120 minutes though, just a bit of a push for the channel, but we shall see. The power up. Quite a while, Ed. I don't think there's any timings on this one. This was a 95 minute scenario where we started. And I can't remember when we started it. I think we've been going about half an hour. Red light up ahead of us. Just pull up a bit closer to the light before we stop. Hey Carl, welcome to the channel this evening. Oh, nice, Steve. Very cool. Thank you. Oh, nice, Carl. I love the 9Fs. Lovely loco. Hi, JD. No, I haven't covered it yet, but I am going to, definitely. I've got a blog article already planned for it, and I'm going to do an episode covering some of the other stuff, like audio, video, and weather, that I haven't done so far, actually on the stream itself. So, yes, I'll be covering all of that in both formats. Hey there, Mr. RQ. Welcome to the stream again. Oh, is that this weekend, Carl? Oh, Saturday the 14th, okay. Yeah, it should be an interesting hill ticket going on again. You're right, JJ. Yes, Ed, what we're going to have is absolute nuts weather. It's going to be snowing, then sunny, then foggy, then not doing anything at all. Because just make it so that as you proceed down the line, so the weather changes dramatically. Bitten's finished her mainline ticket now, hasn't she? You can have a snowstorm, JJ Smoothie Hole. With the extended weather blueprint, you can actually dial up the weather to be quite severe. So instead of just saying it's raining, you can actually say how much rain there is and have an absolutely blizzard, amazing storm that the wipers are struggling to keep up with even on full speed. Oh, I've got approach. Let's get going. Crazy weather special. Looks remarkably like a Steve Van Epp scenario. Cranes everywhere. Where's that bright light coming from? Or is it the back of that train? No. What do you mean, Carl? I guess that depends what you're trying to do, Carl. Are you running SSAA? Press the frame rate on, and now the engine switched off. I press Shift Z, not Z, you silly thing. Last time I used a pair of graphics cards was a long time ago with 8800 DTXs. I never really saw the point in the two graphics cards, to be honest. Ended up using one for physics acceleration because that seemed to be the thing to do at the time. FPS at the moment I'm running about 40, but I've got every detail setting turned up to the max and I'm running SSAA 3x3. No, go on, Carl, tell me more. Oh dear. Can't say I've noticed, to be honest. It wouldn't surprise me if people are panicking for nothing. The problem is that they say they've got 4 gigs of RAM and maybe they can only access 3.5. And people will panic they can't have that 500 meg, but they probably have no idea whether they're using even anywhere near the 3.5 gig. So people just panic because a number is smaller than they thought it was. It's just not worth worrying about. Is the machine working properly? Then leave it alone. Yeah, coming down the hill is a good exercise in braking, Ed. I mean, this is the slowest I've probably seen it run in about. It's running about 35, 40 frames per second at the moment. Most of the roads that I run it on, I get 60 to 70. Hey there, Septile. Thanks for the follow. Much appreciated. To know you're enjoying it as well, except Carl. Hey there, Carl, thanks for the follow, much appreciated. Signal so we can keep going. In fact, it's now an advanced approach, so I'm actually running a bit slow. Primarin. Back on the level again. Well, you should know a SD70M scenario now, Ed. How many AI? The answer is all of them. On the way up, so I've got part of the train coming up before the flat, part of the train on the flat, and another part on the way up. Excellent. Advanced approach on the next signal so we can keep going. think my favourite locos are probably... I've got lots of different favourite locos depending on what I'm doing. So if I'm interested in American stuff, then a favourite loco of, say, the Jinty or the 2F Top Tank or the J94 is really not appropriate. We just caught that one. Wasn't watching that signal. Couplings, what couplings? Fatal Abuse, welcome to the channel this evening. Well, it doesn't hurt, Ed, that I've got 16,000 horsepower on the, 12,000 horsepower, sorry, on the bottom of the back of the train. Hurry up to heading for Midas. So our end point is... Where is it? 16 miles away. Hey there, Nick and Travis, welcome to the channel this evening. It's not really all down to what dovetail want to do. If it's not offered, then then it doesn't get published. Hey Septar, this scenario is Colfax East to Camp Spalding on Steam Workshop by Steam Planet. His username is Steve Van. Steve's actually on the channel, so say hi. A 9F on Donna Pass. See, now there you go, Carl. I like that idea. Off the power a bit, trying to avoid speeding. You know, sometimes I think if Dovetail made a realistic and after a completely fictional train, they'd still be told it doesn't sound right. You can take your train there if you want, Doc. I'm not going anywhere near it. I think the funniest one I ever saw was when TS-15 came out, which had obviously the 801, and people told us that it didn't sound right. But even in reality, the 801 didn't have motors yet. So how does anyone know? why will the fire need a new simulator, Doc? Hey Ray Reds, welcome to the channel this evening. Hey Bryozon, Bryozon and Chris Boss, welcome back. Oh, Fira. Wow, that's interesting, Poplover. Not much to say about that train then, is there? Doesn't seem like a roiling success. Two and a half percent, not Jay. Hey, Will and Sitting, welcome back to the channel. Or Budgie, sorry, I remember now, it's Budgie, isn't it? Hey Jim Binks and Prototype, welcome to the channel this evening. Still making our way up. Got three more, two more Novias, then we've got two stops. Hey Budgie, thanks for the follow, much appreciated. Hey Travis and Sir Carlos, welcome to the channel this evening. loud in the cab. Step back a minute, let our ears have a rest. Going into tunnel one. Hey, Jabber Eats Pizza Hut, welcome to the channel this evening. So we've gone up a 2.4% grade at the moment, and we're running in notch 8, so flat out. Obviously very nicely balanced with this train, Steve. Hey there, QWERTY Afro, welcome to the channel this evening. We've got advanced approach on our next signal. Another rule 14L fail. Hey HD Gaming, welcome to the channel this evening. I'm very good, thank you, HD Gaming. We are slowly accelerating in Notch 8, just about beating it. A whole new computer, just temporarily this weekend, HD Gaming. I'm borrowing my machine from the office, which was for the... for the festival on Friday, so yeah, it is quite a different setup this weekend. I'll be back to my laptop as of Monday. Same microphone though, ironically, but very, very different sound card. Whereas I'm using the built-in laptop one on my laptop, my desktop has got a Soundblaster Z in it. Hey, Little Small, welcome to the channel this evening. Has someone, who's got a current count on the number of followers we've got? Because we're getting dangerously close to 400. I think if I have to dismantle my computer and bring it home and then dismantle everything else and bring it away, then I think I'd be crazy doing that every week. We're at 398. Wow! Who to go? If you haven't pressed follow, press follow! Hey DG Warrior, thanks for the follow, much appreciated. That in theory means we're at 399. We are at 400 followers. Wow, that's fantastic news. Ah! I was wondering what that noise was in the background. It's because I loaded Twitch up. Right, what have we got? Advanced approach, so we carry on going. We are going to go via the balloon loop, 0.6 miles. I just re-went into twitch.tv and it said 400. Hi DG Warrior, good to have you with us. Hey, Steven Spielnacker. Thanks very much for the follow, much appreciated. Welcome, Justin. Have you with us this evening? UP4752 at loop, track 2. Stop at emigrant gap, track 2 east signals to pick up two bigwigs, suits, to take to Camp Spalding. Try to stop as close as you can so they don't have to walk too far. Well, I want them to walk far because they're suits and, you know, I hate the man. Miles to get to there. Why am I leaving that on the screen? Go away. Hey there, Curly Fries, welcome back. My head caught in the trees. Hey, welcome back, Pocket Player. That's no excuse, Doc. Tell the teacher to wait for a minute while you take a couple of pictures. I do what I do. My watch is one of these smartwatch things. It's got a camera built into it, so you can just, you know, lean there like this and click, and it'll take the picture for you. Not a very good one, but it takes a picture. Got another advanced approach. Yeah, Coplopper, at this point in time, until someone else steps up to do them, then all of the streams, the live streams, will be done by me. If someone else wants to do it, then they'll be more than welcome to. We're stopping at Emigrant Track, Track 2, over here. Emigrant, Emigrant Gap, Track 2. So the signal's allowing us to proceed, but we've been told to stop, so we will. Oh yes, we've got to go and pick up the suits. Yeah, good pictures, Dean. UP 3151 at Emigrant Gap. Drop the two men off just before your destination point. You'll see their classic cars parked there. I need you to hold there until West UP 3151 oil train passes by, and then you can move up to the signal bridge and stop to end the scenario. Classic cars parked just before our ending. Alright then, fair enough, I can do that, hopefully. Camp Spalding, 3.85 miles. You're probably right, look, you just... Welcome, Ademio. Thank you. Thanks for joining us. Hey, Bad Hair 1963, welcome to the channel and thanks for the follow, much appreciated. I don't know if there's going to be a stream yet tomorrow, Dean. Best way is to keep an eye out on Facebook. But failing that, I'll be back on Monday. And sometime this week, I'm going to do the German special. As soon as I've figured out how to drive PZB. It's not up to me, Copper, I'm afraid. I'll take a look at that after the chat then, Coplopper. Welcome, Crazy Brooklyn. Good to have you with us. So what are we now? Just under 2 miles to Camp Spalding. We've got to drop the dignitaries off just before our termination point. And then hold there for... hold there for another train to pass us. Hey there, Durzan. Welcome to the chat this evening. The channel, sorry. Good to have you with us. Hey, Kay Watson. Welcome to the channel too. Good to have you with us as well. It's half past midnight. I'm apparently losing the ability to speak coherently. Hey, Kay Watson, thanks for the follow. Much appreciated. Mine too, Kay Watson. Mine too. That's pretty awesome. Which trains? Which country? Nice. Oh, very nice, Kay Watson. Most of our stuff is 00 gauge UK stuff, but we've got a few bits of HO gauge. We've got the Backman Acela, got an FEC, SD70. I can't remember what SD70 it is now. Might be a Mac. What else have we got? Skippy 40, we've got three or four of those. got a fair few steam engines, like cab facey 12 cab forward, Challenger, big boy. This is all on a British layout. Well, it's not a British layout, but everything. We've got German trains, American trains, but Romanian trains. I think it's Romanian, the Blue Tiger. Hey, RSW077, thanks for the follow, much appreciated. My son generally likes the Japanese stuff, so we've got the set we have here is N-gauge, and it's basically things like Shinkansen trains. Oh wow, well, if you've got a hobby shop, that makes it a bit easier, Kay Watson, very good. Just take a trip. Is this where our classic cars are? Yep, there they are. No, I said Shinkansen for N-gauge, Doppler. Why is he waiting there? Hey Kay Watson, it's a green screen. I'm afraid my shed looks considerably more messy than this. I'm holding back here, Poplopper, because the instructions said hold before your termination point and next to the cars, so that's what I'm doing. Hopefully Steve can correct me if I'm doing the wrong thing here. Please do, Kay Watson. Hey Doc, the instructions said to stop before the marker, wait for this train to go by, and then go up to the track, the train, to the marker once the train has passed, which is what I'm doing. For once in my life, I'm reading the instructions and doing as I'm told. Hey there, Ultimate Insane Gamer, welcome to the channel. Bravo, UP4752, you made it to Camp Spaulding. Great job, Donna Dispatcher Thompson out. Very good. Thank you very much, Steve, for the scenario. That was Colfax East to Camp Spaulding by Steve Vanetz. Username is Steve Van on Steam. You can download that from Steam Workshop. Superb. Right. Oh, the ringing silence. Right, well, it's 20 to 1, and I think that's all we've got time for tonight. Hope you all enjoyed the show. It's a bit of a different one. We do in terms of we don't normally do a Saturday show, but I thought I'd give it a try, since I was probably going to be here either watching TV or playing Train Sim anyway. Might as well stream it. I don't know if there's going to be a show on Sunday. I think that will probably be a day off. Keep an eye out on Facebook and Twitter. And if there's going to be a show, I'll say so. If there isn't, then I won't. So just let me know about... I'll let you know via those channels. Failing that, I will see you all on Monday. So thanks very much, and I'll catch you later.